Today is the day that I joined the router lift set, and I've got a Jessem Mast-R-Lift II, which is their top of the line lift for big heavy body router motors, and I bought the Milwuakee 5625. Now the reason I bought this is, for one thing, I'm a big Milwuakee fan, and the reason I bought this over the Porter Cable was because when I bought this for the same price as the just the Porter Cable body, this came with a collet and it also came with the router handles. And so if I ever wanted to take this out of the lift, if I needed a fourth router to use in my shop for some reason, I've got this. So I thought, why not get it? And I also read some reviews where this is substantially quieter than the Porter Cable. And that always helps too. But I'm a big Milwuakee fan. But there are several reasons I chose the Jessem. And that one of the reasons is that it has a universal motor grabbing mechanism built into it, so it handles a whole variety of different routers. So what if this router failed, or I needed it for something else, and so I wanted to put a different router body in it? Well, this is going to accept that with no problem. You know, most of the other ones pretty much only handle that Porter Cable style router body. So, and I wanted something that was just a little bit more versatile. I also really like the way this uses just one tool to manipulate all the raise and lower and locking functions of the lift. And so I thought that was very clever too. And but I looked at all of them. I looked at bench dog. I looked at woodpeckers. I looked at Incra, and I just really felt that this one is just going to be the best for my needs, and be the most versatile for the long term. So let me open these guys up and let's take a look at them. Here, let's open this router first. I'm sure this router is no longer made in the U.S. I haven't looked at the manufacturer plate, but I'm sure that it's probably Chinese now, but what are you going to do? Yeah, that's not that heavy, you know. My big Festool router is heavier than that. My Makita 3612 is heavier than this, too. So there may be some times where I want to take this out and use it like this. And so here's the locking mechanism here, and it probably just have to thread it all the way out to get the motor out. So there's the motor. It comes with a collet, a half inch collet, and so I like it. And so I'll just put this up on the shelf, and when I need it, it's there. So let's open up this beauty here. Woo, that's pretty. One fine looking precision machine there. But I think you can get an idea of why I found this so appealing. It has these universal motor grabbing blocks on it, and they're adjustable. You can see it's got different positions, so this is going to be a very nice long-term solution. Like I said, if this router motor should fail, or if I wanted to use a different one in it, the same lift is going to work without any without any problem. So let's look at how my dimensions. Now that is just exactly where I had said it was going to be, right there. It's even exactly on my pencil lines. So that's absolutely perfect. Okay, well, I'll wait to put the motor in until after I do my router work down into the table. So let me prepare for that, and I'm going to use my Festool multifunction jig, and I'm going to set the multifunction jig up to cut this exact size, and then and I'm going to do it in a piece of plywood first, a piece of scrap first, before I cut into my top and make an error until I'm really absolutely 100% sure that I'm ready. Okay, let me get the rest of these parts laid out and start getting my router setup going. Okay, so I just got finished setting up my Festool multi-routing template, and I made all my calculations. I'm using a 40 millimeter guide bushing, but I'm using a 1-inch bearing, but I just made a conversion to everything into metric, just because it's easier. And I know my base is exactly 11 3/4 by 9 1/4, so I just made a conversion and then did my calculations, and I'll take pictures of this. And I cut it one time and it was just a little bit loose, so I had to make just one micro adjustment, and now I've got this down to where I'm a half a millimeter. I got a half a millimeter of slop in here, and that's just enough for me to get it in there comfortably and not worry about chipping the laminate by trying to get it in there too tight. And so I cut a practice piece like this. Now, what I want to do is, this thing is pretty heavy. I mean, this thing is pretty heavy. It's a solid, fabricated thing. I mean, it's not light duty. And then that router is pretty heavy too. So it's going to be a lot of weight hanging on it. And the way you level this off is with set screws. But since I have wood, plywood, and the Baltic birch is pretty tough, but it's not tough enough to withstand the constant weight and pressure of that. It would eventually make dimples and depressions into the plywood. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this piece, and I'm going to trace this onto a piece of 1/16 of an inch plate steel, thin sheet steel that I have. And I'm going to cut it out, and then I'm going to cut a 3/4 inch mark out of the inside, and it's going to be a liner, a pan or a liner, that's going to sit down inside the rabbet in my plywood, and that's actually what the set screws are going to pull to. I'm only having to give up a 1/16 of an inch because of this steel. So let me show you this piece of steel that I have. I got it at my one of my favorite metal places here in Austin, my favorite metal place here in Austin, Westbrook Metals. And this was free because I had bought some other stuff, and whenever you buy other stuff, they're so nice that you just go back where the big shears are and you go, hey, do you got any drops that I can have? And they just, as it's coming off the shear and it doesn't meet the order that they're filling out, they just put it in these partitions, and they go, oh yeah, just take whatever you can carry. So I just grabbed a few pieces, and this is one of the ones. So I'd like to thank Brain Edwards for this piece of steel. I'm sure it was really supposed to be Brian Edwards, but oh, there's a big silverfish right there. Brain Edwards, thank you very much, and it'll go to good use. So let me trace my piece out, and I'm going to go outside and cut it with a jigsaw.